Good morning, Little Zion Church family.
Thank you all for joining our live stream service.
I know many of you are watching on Facebook Live,
YouTube,
Livestream,
Roku TV,
and listening in on the conference call.
We're excited that you have tuned in because we have a powerful word for you today.
And you don't want to miss it.
So on behalf of our pastor, Earl T. Howardson Jr.
and First Lady Shonda Howardson,
we would like to welcome all of our new viewers for tuning into our live stream service.
And remember, don't forget to share this service with all of your family and friends.
And tag us using hashtag OurLZBC. Enjoy.
Good morning, my brothers and sisters in Christ. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we are here to rejoice and be glad with it. And God is good, and he's greatly to be praised. Come on, let's lift up our voice and give God a shout of praise on today. How many of you are glad to be in the house of the Lord on today? Amen, amen, amen. I don't think your neighbor's convinced that you're excited to be here. Amen. Look at your neighbor and say, I'm so happy to be in the house of the Lord. And I can shout about it. Come on, let's put our hands together. Hallelujah. 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 From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, his name is worthy to be praised. Has he been good to us? Amen, amen. We are ready. Amen. The choir is ready. Come on, family. Let's have church.
Hallelujah. Come on, clap those hands. Hallelujah. Come on, we come to lift up the name of Jesus. We come to give him some glory. Come on, is he higher lifted up? Come on, we give his name the glory. Hallelujah. The song says, Lord, we exalt your name.
that a God who created the earth, created everything, desires to have fellowship with us, and he knows us all individually, and he knows every detail about us, and he wants us to commune with him, have fellowship with him. And it's good to come to the house of prayer, amen, with others that love him, that believe in him, and then we are able to worship him collectively. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Bible says, oh, magnify the Lord with me and let us exalt his name together. Amen. 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 I'm telling you, it's nothing like having something in common with someone and being able to brag about it and boast about it. When was the last time you bragged on God? I know some of y'all got to think about it because it's been a while, but for those who really know where your blessings come from, know where your help come from, and you're not ashamed to give God what he deserves, I'm telling you, ain't nothing like bragging on God because he's been so good. Amen, 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 amen. If you've ever been healed by the Lord and you know it was God, and you start talking about how the Lord healed you and how he helped you, how he made a way for you. Amen. It's something about boasting in the Lord. Amen, amen, amen. David said, I'll make my boast in the Lord. The humble will hear thereof and be glad. Amen, amen. As we're preparing now, we're going to have our scripture reading followed by words of prayer and then our welcome. Amen.
Chapter 55, verses 1 through 9. Ho, everyone who thirsts, come to the waters, and you who have no money, come buy and eat. Yes, come buy wine and milk without money and without price. Why do you spend money for what is not bread, and your wages for what does not satisfy?
All right.
Listen carefully to me and eat what is good, and let your soul delight itself in abundance. Incline your ear and come to me. Hear, and your soul shall live, and I will make an everlasting covenant with you. The sure mercies of David, indeed I have given him as a witness to the people, a leader and commander for the people. Surely you shall call a nation you do not know, and nations who do not know you shall run to you.
Yes.
Because of the Lord your God and the Holy One of Israel, for he has glorified you. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts. Let him return to the Lord, and he will have mercy on him, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are my ways your ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. May God add a blessing upon you.
Word is good. Amen. Amen. As we prepare our hearts and minds for prayer, we certainly would love to invite those who desire to come to the altar. Amen. We know prayer changes things and prayer changes people. Amen. Amen. We know that as we solicit our prayers and petitions unto the Lord, even though collectively we come together, there are some personal things that's just between you and God. There are times when you come to the altar and you take the initiative and take a step, is initiating once again your faith and saying, God, I'm believing that if I step out, I'm believing, God, if I make my request known, that you will move on our behalf. And so we believe that there is power in prayer. We want to pray for Brother Romeo Saunders, who's at VCU Medical Center, had surgery following a broken leg on yesterday, I think, Little League Pee Wee football, and someone fell on his leg, broke his leg. We want to pray for him that he will have a complete 100% recovery.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Brother Merrill Purse, continue to pray for him at VCU Medical Center. Brother James Wood, Trustee Kip Wood's dad's recovering from surgery, praying for him as well. Sister Louise Wilson at Bonsecure's praying for her. Brother Marshall Wilson's mother. Also, Sister Betty Dow has asked that we pray for her, keep her in our prayers as well. And then pray for Gregory Bankhead's son, who had surgery this past week, praying for him. Continue to pray for those who have lost family members and loved ones. Certainly praying for Brother Ellis and Avis Ivy, praying that God will continue to strengthen them. Had a marvelous homegoing with Brother Bernard yesterday. And, the love and the support that was shown. And we just thank God once again that God is still in control, and we're trusting that God will continue to take care of each and every one of us. For those of you who are here today, those who are watching, and praying that God will continue to bless, how many of you know that the Lord has been good to you this week? Not only do we pray for the things and petitions that we want God to do, but once again, we also pray that God will continue to bless and open doors as he has been in the past. Praying for our children as they return to school, and some are returning to school. Praying for the teachers, amen, the administration as well, and praying for the parents and grandparents. Amen. Pray for all of those, and just praying for our church family that God will continue to strengthen us and draw us closer together, and then raise up men, women, boys, and girls who desires to serve and to seek the Lord. Amen. We are grateful that Reverend Annie is going to go to the throne of grace for us today. Amen.
For those that are in the congregation and those that are watching on YouTube, Roku, and in you streaming, we just ask that you come to the throne, lay your burdens on the altar, and give them unto God. We know that, as the scripture was said, his thoughts are not ours, his ways are not ours. But we thank God that he knows what is best for us, and he will not put more on us than we can bear. And Father God, we come to you this morning just thanking you. God, we honor you, we praise you for being our Lord, our Savior, and our King. God, we thank you right now in the name of Jesus, because if it had not been for you that was on our side, where on earth would we be? God, we thank you right now for all of your promises. God, we thank you for your forgiveness, God. God, we ask right now in the name of Jesus Christ that you would forgive us as you forgive us, God. We ask that you would give us, Lord God, the strength to forgive those that have sinned against you, Lord God, those that have persecuted us, God, in the name of Jesus Christ, so that we continue to stay in right standing with you, God. Help us to forgive and forgive and continue to forgive in the name of Jesus Christ. God, you heard all of the petitions, all of the names that were called out, that was put in the atmosphere. God, we know that your ear was attentive, and God, we thank you that you're already working on it, God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Because God, we thank you because we do know you as a healer, God, in the name of Jesus. We know you as a deliverer. We know you as a way maker and a burden bearer. We know you as a heavy load sharer. God, we know that you're always with us, because you promised in your word that you would never leave us, nor will you forsake us, nor will you leave your seed, our seed, begging for bread. So God, we thank you right now. We mostly thank you, God, because you promised in your word that you would not put more on us than we can bear. So God, we thank you when we feel like we're being overburdened. God, help us to cast our cares upon you, because we know that you care for us. We know that you love us, God. And God, we thank you right now in the name of Jesus Christ for always being with us. We thank you most of all, God, for loving us, God, when we even didn't love ourselves. God, we thank you even, Lord, when we talked about somebody, when we went somewhere that we didn't need to go, God, that you still loved us, God. And not only that, God, we thank you for your grace and your mercy that you grant us daily, God, in the name of Jesus Christ. God, you heard the petitions, Lord God, of those that have lost loved ones. Comfort them, God, like only you can. God, we know to be absent from the body is to be present with you. And God, we thank you that you sent your darling son
that he took the sting out of the grave. So God, we thank you. We glorify you, God, that now we're in the presence of God. So God, we thank you, Lord God. Comfort the hurting and broken hearts, God. Know, God, that without a doubt, God, that if they died in you, God, that we will see our ones again in the name of Jesus Christ. God, we love you. We adore you. We honor you, God. Now we ask that you have your way in this place today. God, we pray that you anoint the evangelist, the preacher of the hour. God, anoint our first lady in the name of Jesus. From the top of her head to the soles of her feet. Use her, God, like you have never used her before, God. Let the words out of her mouth and the meditation of her heart be acceptable in your sight, God. God, who is her redeemer and her strength? In the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, let your word penetrate our heart, God. Prepare our hearts, our minds, our soul, and our spirit to receive, God, what you have for us this day. In the name of Jesus Christ. We thank you. We love you. We adore you. We honor you, God, because you and you alone are worthy of all of our praise. God, we thank you, God. We glorify you, God. We honor you, God. Now let us have an experience in you today, God, like we've never had before, God. Let every burden be lifted in the name of Jesus, because you are good and you are worthy to be praised. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Hallelujah and praise the Lord. And let everything that we do today, God, give you glory, give you honor, and give you praise. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
On this wonderful first Sunday in the month of September. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. September is here,
yes.
And we certainly would like to recognize those who are blessed to be born during the month of September. If you are here and you are blessed to be born during the month of September, might you stand? Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Happy birthday to our September birthday persons. Amen. God is good. God is good. Amen. Amen. And then those who are blessed to be married during the month of September, if you might stand. Happy anniversary. Happy anniversary. Happy anniversary. Amen. Hold on, y'all. Keep standing. How many years? How many years? 29 years, amen. 29 years, amen. 22 years, Ivy's, amen. 15 years, 11 years, amen. 31 years, oh my. 7 years. Amen. Amen. Is that everybody? Amen. Come on, let's give them a hand. We certainly thank God and appreciate for those who are continuing to celebrate, whether it be your anniversaries or your birthdays. We certainly recognize and appreciate those milestones. Amen. Just a couple of things to highlight. We did receive a couple of thank you cards. The Dillon family sent a thank you card once again for the prayers of the church, as well as we did receive a thank you card from Sister Sharika Brown for the graduation gift. Amen. Amen. On September 15th, we do have an engagement at the Church of Deliverance. I believe it's a Friday night revival service at 7 o'clock p.m. And so we do encourage those persons who will travel with us to come and support as we go once again on the 15th. Amen. Amen. The Lord has been kind to us, and we are still rejoicing and celebrating over the past months, the revival and homecoming that we had last month, and now that we're moving into September, praying that God will continue to bless us, to be with us. We will resume our Bible study on Wednesdays. Our Sunday school, I believe we have new material coming in, and so we're looking forward to our Sunday school. For those of you who desire to come to take part in our Sunday school, starts at 8 o'clock. Amen. And then our Monday school, 12 noon, with our Zoom line. The men's ministry will be meeting on the 10th, next Sunday after service. The men want to get together, and we need all the men who can pull up real quick after service. And there's a short meeting. We want to discuss some things, and but we need your help. And so, so men, can we count on you to show up next Sunday after service real quick? Amen. Thank you so much. We have some things that we want to try and do this coming fall, and we need to quick pull up and to discuss some things. And I believe you, the men, are going to enjoy it. I believe the church will enjoy it as well. And so, so thank you so much for your cooperation. Amen. Amen. We are blessed here at Little Zion to be able to do some of the things that the Lord has allowed us to do, and we've made it through the summer months, and as we enter into the fall, I pray that we will get refocused in terms of how we're going to move in ministry. There's some things that we'll be laying out for the remainder of the year so that we can all be on one accord and so that we can continue to do what God has called us to do. I believe that the Lord has positioned us to be able to serve. Amen. Amen. And so there are some areas that we want to kind of improve upon and see how we can serve the church as well as the community in a much broader way. And I certainly know that God has already given us what we need, and we are praying that he will continue to raise up people who's excited about ministry, excited about reaching out to people, and excited about doing God's work. Amen. 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 So you're going to be hearing a little more for those who are still looking at what ministries you want to get involved in. Amen. We certainly pray that the Lord will speak to your heart. Amen. And that you will get involved. Amen. Sometimes all you got to do is just get involved. Amen. And you learn as you go. Nobody knows everything all at once. And sometimes it's just by application that you begin to learn more about things. And even if you get involved and you decide or determine that maybe that wasn't for you, then it's okay. No harm, no foul. Amen. You can try something else. Amen. But I want us to be used in the kingdom so that we can exercise our gifts. There's some gifts that are not going to develop or grow unless they're exercised. Amen. Amen. How many of you work out? Amen. You work out in the gym. Amen. I got to clarify this. Yeah. Pushing yourself to the table. Don't qualify. Amen. Amen. Walking up and down the steps, you know, don't qualify. I mean, I'm talking about you actually working out. Amen. Amen. And you know, people, they work out. They on the phone talking and walking and sharing with somebody. They said they worked out about 30 minutes. I said, you ain't break a sweat. You ain't work out. And so but when you work out, if you wanna get stronger, if you wanna see results, then you have to push beyond your limits of comfort. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. If you're weightlifting, the only way you're gonna get stronger is you gotta lift heavier weights. That your muscles will have to adjust. That you'll put some strain on them. And so, in ministry, if you wanna grow and exercise your gifts, there are times that God will put you in some uncomfortable situations. I never forget when I really first started growing in the Lord. I'm praying for all of these things that I want God to do for me, and I want to be able to do X, Y, and Z. And God began to put me into some situations where they were uncomfortable. And I had to deal with people who were uncomfortable to deal with. And I'm like, why, God, why you, you know, have me dealing with this person? They difficult. And give me somebody that I can get along with. And that's not how God operates. He will put you with some people that rub you the wrong way. I mean, rub you every way but raw. And it tests that kindness and humility that you bring. You know how people, when you speak to them initially, hey, how you, oh, God bless you, I'm fine. But then as soon as they rub you the wrong way, the ugly come out. And you say, wait a minute, where was all of that church stuff? But the more you allow God to put you in some situations that tries your faith, and you have to love people that are seemingly unlovable, it will develop maturity. Amen. And it will develop some long suffering. And even when people rub you the wrong way, it'll be okay, because you know this is a part of the process. God loves them anyway, and you're not going to allow them to pull you to a place where you used to be. Look at your neighbor and say, I used to be something. Look at your neighbor and say, I know all about it. Listen, there's some folk who used to be a handful to deal with. But thanks be to God. Amen. And he's matured some of us. Amen. 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 So don't shy away from conflict at times and confrontation. Amen. If God can develop you here, he can develop you outside of here. The church is a place, once again, where you get developed. And so when you go out, amen, you will react differently because you have been prepared. And so we pray that God will help us to grow and strengthen our gifts. Amen. There are times where, I mean, I don't know, the Lord might just call upon you to just come out spontaneously and read scripture or something, or sing a song. You may not even get a week's notice. It may just be like, I just might look out and say, hey, you know, the Lord just moved me to ask you to just come and just give a greeting. Now, I wouldn't ask you to do something you couldn't do. Amen. But for those of you who stay on ready, like, I don't believe the deacon or deaconess need a whole lot of warning to pray.
Amen.
Is that safe to say?
Yeah.
I mean, you a deacon, deaconess, associate minister.
Amen.
You ought to be able to pray.
Amen.
Because you ought to be praying during the week.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. If you are musically gifted and you can minister, now I ain't saying perform. Now, if you was performing, you need preparation. But if you don't minister, you will allow the Lord to use your gifts. Amen. And so I pray that the kingdom, the church, would have persons who are available once again, that God might use us, whether we be here or someone else. How many of you want to be used? See, here's the thing, because we have people who do things all the time, but there are times where persons, once again, out the blue, spontaneously, the Lord will allow someone to rise up and to speak, to share, to minister, and you never know, there's someone who connects with you so much that you may not even know them, but just your spirit does something for them and reaches them and touches them. I talk to persons oftentimes and say, well, such and such prayed, and when they prayed, I was in tears, and it just did something to my spirit, did something to my soul. It just hit me in a place, and you may be able to reach persons with your prayer that I may not be able to reach that particular day. And so just being available, and you don't even have to have the microphone. You can just be sitting next to someone, and you can just give them a hug, and God will allow some healing or some help or hope to transfer and be a blessing to them. Amen. Somebody ought to say, Lord, any way you want to bless me, any way you want to bless me, I will be satisfied. Amen, amen, amen. As we continue to move forward, amen, I just want to take this opportunity to thank all of our guests and visitors, amen. I think we have the Browns in the house. That's the Brown family. Amen. Pop Brown is in the house. Amen. He was in some rough shape some months ago, I believe Easter, and he was in the hospital and it wasn't looking good, but they prayed and the Lord turned it around and he's here in Jesus' name. Come on, come on, somebody ought to shout hallelujah. 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 Ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? Oh, I'm telling you, amen. You just don't know how close, amen. Amen, amen. It could have been a homegoing preparation, but no, the Lord said no. We're going to celebrate him, amen. And we thank God for his life. We thank God for his fight, his determination, amen. God is good. He's good. He's good. And he's worthy to be praised, amen. Amen. Why don't you just reach over and give somebody a hug and a handshake? Let them know you are glad to see them, glad to have them in the house of the Lord. God is good and he is greatly to be praised, amen. Gotta buy crabs for everybody. Church 2, Jumbo. Who was it? Destiny? Destiny? All right. Number one, ma'am. Extra seasoning. Amen. Y'all see how family threw you under the bus? We're going to prepare to go a little bit further and prepare for our offering, amen, and ask that our officers will come forward, amen, as we prepare to give, amen, as the Lord has blessed us. God is good, and he's greatly to be praised, amen. The Bible says, if we give, it shall be given good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, shall men give into your bosom, amen. We pray that we will come and give as the Lord has blessed us. Ushers.
Thank you. presence in the house, oh God. We thank you for your mercy and your graces, oh God. Continue to bless us, oh God. So many of your people, oh God, this morning have believed in your word, oh God. Your word says, bring your gifts, bring your tithes into the storehouse so that there may be food in my house. Test me on this, says the Lord, and see if I don't open up the floodgates of heaven and pour you out a blessing you will not have room to receive. So we thank you, dear God, for every blessing that you've already given us, oh God, that you continue to give us, oh God. We honor you, we worship you, we glorify you. We thank you for this opportunity. In Jesus' name we pray.
Challenges, some streaming challenges with Facebook, and so for those who are watching, I think YouTube is maybe a little bit better, amen. So praying that God will continue to bless, amen. As we're preparing our hearts and minds now for the Word of God, we're grateful to have First Lady Ms. Deshonda Howard. Sharing for Sister McLaughlin's 39th anniversary, pastoral minister anniversary. And we're grateful that the Robinsons were there to support First Lady. Amen, amen. We thank them so much for going, traveling all the way to Petersburg. Amen. And when I got home, she said, can you believe that the Robinsons were there? I said, I forgot to tell you that they made showed up. Amen. Well, that's a blessing, and thank you all so much for support. Amen. She can preach, and she will preach. Amen. Amen. She has her own unique personality and style, and she is herself. Amen. And so that's what matters. Amen. And so we pray that the Lord will speak to her and then speak through her.
Amen.
And then speak to us in that particular right. So we pray that God will use her.
Amen.
And that when we leave here, we are better because we were here. Amen. Amen. As the choir prepares to come, they throwing down, y'all. The choir is throwing down.
Amen.
They prepare to come and minister once again. Amen. We are going to hear from our First Lady, Minister Deshonda Joy Howerton. Amen.
Song says, fully committed to you, Lord. How many of you want to be committed to the Lord? Truly committed to the Lord. Can you say yes to his will? And will you say yes to his way? But God is calling us to be fully committed to him.
I'll say yes, I'll say yes, yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. we'll stand back in a moment just to read the scriptures, but I just want to say thank God for one more day. Amen. I thank God for one more rising this morning and allowing me to see a day that I've never seen before. Amen. I thank God for the opportunity to stand behind the sacred desk today as well as last Sunday. Amen. Thank God for our esteemed pastor, Reverend Earl T. Howerton Jr. Amen. And I thank God for my mama and my boys. Amen. Amen. And I thank God for each and every one of you all this morning. Pastor has already said much of what I prepared to say this morning, so I'm going to say the benediction. Amen. And that's good because that means we're on one accord. I didn't share anything with him, and I'm just sitting there in amazement like, God, you have done it again. But I do want to thank the Robinsons as well for supporting me. I was so very surprised to see them at the end. I thank you all so much for traveling to hear with this big old mouth how God was going to use it. Amen. And as I sat there, yes. Yes, ma'am. Shows that what happens when we're fully committed to God. Amen. All you got to do is commit to God. Hey, glory to God. Don't worry about the way being made. Just commit to God. Come on here. He'll clear up the rain. All you got to do is believe and be committed to God. Good God Almighty. I thank you for sharing that. Amen. As I sat there last Sunday with the McLaughlins, 39 years of ministry. They said when they went there, they were 26 and 28. Amen. 39 years, Pastor, we got 24 more to go, amen? But I just thought about the toiling and the prayers and the seeing the families grow and, you know, all the things, and we just getting started, y'all. Amen. Shoot, hey, glory to God. All right, y'all can stand to your feet. I'm going to read the scripture. I'm going to set my watch. We're going to do what we got came to do, amen? There is a word from the Lord. How about that? There is a word from the Lord. It is found in 2 Corinthians 1. 2 Corinthians 1. Now, I'm going to be reading from the Message translation. Amen. If you don't have it, it's okay just to listen. 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verses 3 and 4, and then 8 through 11. The Message is a little tricky how they kind of categorize the verses together. Amen. 2 Corinthians 1, 3 and 4, and then 8 and 11. Amen? Amen? Amen. It says, all praise to the God and Father of our Master, Jesus the Messiah.
Yes.
Father of all mercy, God of all healing counsel. He comes alongside us when we go through hard times. Yeah. And before you know it, He brings us alongside someone else who is going through hard times so that we can be there for that person just as God was there for us. We have plenty of hard times that come from following the Messiah, right? But we fully committed. But no more so than the good times of his healing comfort, we get a full measure of that too. Amen? Let's jump on down to verse 8. It says, we don't want you in the dark, friends, about how hard it was when all this came down on us in Asia province. It was so bad, we didn't think we were going to make it. We felt like we'd been sent to death row, and that it was all over for us. As it turned out, y'all, it was the best thing that could have happened. Instead of trusting in our own strength or wits to get out of it, we were forced to trust God totally. Not a bad idea, since he's the God who raises the dead, all right? And he did it, y'all. He rescued us from certain doom. And he'll do it again, rescuing us as many times as we need rescuing. Good God Almighty. Let's just stop right there. Amen. Somebody just give God a hand clap of praise for the word of God. Amen. Woo, that's good news. Father God, we just thank you, Lord, even now for this preaching hour, God. We thank you for this preaching time, God. God, I ask now that you would just saturate me, drench me with your anointing and your Holy Ghost. Hallelujah, God. Allow the words that roll off my tongue, God, be impactful. Let them be life-changing because you are in them. God, I thank you for the ears that will hear on this morning, God. I thank you for transformation, God. I thank you for elevation, for revelation. God, I thank you for being everything that we stand in need of on this morning, God. Unless you do it, God, it won't be done. But God, if you're in the midst of it, my God. So God, we are waiting. We're waiting for you, God. Have your way in this place. Have your way in me, God. Use me. Speak to me and speak through me so that you will get the honor and the glory. In Jesus' name we pray and we say amen.
Amen.
Amen. You all may take your seats this morning as I use for my sermon topic, God loves and cares for you. Amen. God loves and cares for you. In 2 Corinthians 1, we find Paul seeking to address the concerns, the doubts, and the misunderstandings that have arisen among the Corinthians. He even shares his personal experiences, encouraging them to trust in God's comfort as he reaffirms his commitment, ain't that something, y'all, to them, and defends his apostolic authority. Isn't it something when we are on one accord with the Lord, amen? Every song that has been sung, every prayer that has been prayed, even when Pastor came this morning, we are all on one accord, amen? Ultimately, Paul's aim was to strengthen their faith, to restore unity, and deepen their understanding of God's faithfulness and the mess, in their mess of trials and challenges, amen? As we look at the latter verses, verses 8 through 11, we gain insight into the trouble that Paul and his counterparts faced while doing ministry. Remember, ministry simply means service. Paul said that he has written these things. He has shared these things so that the people of Corinth and us too this morning, right, would not be left in the dark about the trouble that they experienced in Asia. I believe that Paul is saying, listen, don't get it twisted, right? I may make it look easy, but baby, serving the Lord takes courage, it takes faith, and it takes enduring uncomfortable situations sometimes. Even sometimes we have to endure things beyond what we think we can handle. I believe it is this reason that mature Christians don't respond the way they feel when they're offended. Amen. Pastor alluded to that, right? When he talked about our gifts and how we, the more we use them, the more we are able to handle some uncomfortable situations. It was a setup. Somebody say setup. It was a setup this morning. My God, today, right? Mature Christians who have endured some things don't respond every time somebody gets out of pocket, right? You don't react immediately. You take your time and you think about if your response is even worth their time. Amen? Hallelujah. Glory to God. I love it. Whoo, Paul, one of the greatest apostles of Christ Jesus. Y'all know he was responsible for writing 13 of the 27 books in the New Testament? Paul was a bad man, but in a good way, amen? It's the same Paul here that we find saying that he was troubled and thought he was on death row. It's the same Paul who we used to call Saul before his Damascus Road experience, amen? It's the same Paul who goes on to say that the sufferings he endured was so bad that he thought he wasn't going to make it. He said the mistreatment that he faced again was so bad that he felt like he was on death row. Now, immediately, John, I thought about Death Row Records, but we not going to do that. That ain't what we came to do today. Amen. Praise the Lord. For y'all that don't know nothing about Death Row Records, don't even worry about it. Amen. But I'm just saying. Hey, glory to God. But that's a rapper. That's a rapper's label. Don't worry about it. Amen. You know, Suge Knight and them, you know. But now, you got to know that's pretty bad when you're going through and you feel like you're on death row. It's interesting because Paul even admitted in Acts 26, 10 through 11 to King Agrippa. He said, listen, I was so bad that this is what I did while I was in Jerusalem under the authority of the chief priests. I put many of the Lord's people in prison. And when they were put to death, it was me that I cast my vote many a time and went from one synagogue to another to have them punished. And I tried to force them into blasphemy. I was so upset. I'm so obsessed, with persecuting them that I even hunted them down in foreign cities. This Paul here now finds himself on the other side of what he did to other people. Tell somebody, God's got a way of turning some things around. Amen. So, you know, Paul knew firsthand what it meant to be treated harshly without any hope in sight. But as God would have it, you know, God has a way of making us remember how we treated other people. Amen. So I want to encourage you this morning to treat everybody right and you ain't got to worry about it. Present day death row is not much different than it was back in Paul's day. Amen. The inhumane treatment of those waiting to be executed. Can you imagine being in a cell that's not bigger than a parking lot space, all 22 to 23 hours a day by yourself in solitary confinement, and no one to talk to? All you can do is think about what's coming, and it's death. It's inhumane. I was watching a quick clip from Anthony Graves, who is a former or was a former inmate in Texas, and he talks about the conditions on death row. He spent 12 years in solitary confinement, just about losing his mind for a crime that he didn't even commit. But what he said was the way that they are treated on death row is a sure recipe for mental breakdowns beyond repair and the grave for sure. Now, perhaps none of us in here this morning will ever, and I pray never, face the conditions of death row. But I just wonder this morning if anyone under the sound of my voice has ever received a bad or a terminal diagnosis. Have you ever heard or gone to the doctor and you knew it was bad, but it's worse than what you thought it was, amen? Now, I wonder if anybody, and I'm not asking you to raise your hand this morning, but are you in a situation that you didn't realize was going to unfold like this? There's some marriages that feel like they're beyond repair. There's some relationships, amen? Don't just wink at me, amen? That may feel like they are beyond repair. Perhaps you have been in friendship and fellowship with some church folks. Some backstabbing church folks, and it feels like that relationship is what? Beyond repair. Perhaps you've experienced unemployment or the death of a loved one. Maybe an eviction or foreclosure. All while serving the Lord. Because serving the Lord does not make us exempt from trials and tribulations. Amen? And so has anyone here or those that are watching online ever faced a trial or tribulation that you thought was going to take you out? Y'all quiet. Let me talk. Anybody in here ever faced anything that you thought was going to take you out? Yeah? Let's be honest in here. Amen. This morning. Because God is a healer. Amen. Is anyone willing to tell yourself? I mean, just to be honest, it's not even about us this morning. But it's about being honest with yourself and honest with the Lord about what you've been going through. Amen? Amen. Anyone want to testify this morning that they've had some hills to climb? Yeah. That they've had some weary days? Yeah. Oh, and some sleepless nights? Sometimes the clouds, they look low in your life and you can hardly see the road. Yeah. Has anyone other than me ever asked the Lord why? Why? So much pain. Hallelujah. But I'm just so glad to know that God has not left us, nor will he leave us, nor will he forsake us. Amen. When we look at the text, after Paul talks about it, how he was feeling like he was on death row, and he goes on to say, but as it turned out, it was the best thing that could have happened to me.
Amen.
Well, wait a minute, Paul, that don't make sense. How you go from death row to being the best thing that's ever happened? What you say, amen? How in the world could that horrible experience make you feel like, you know what, that was the best thing for me? But if we read down a little bit further, he says, because of instead of trusting in our own strength, in our own wit, we were forced to trust in God totally. Amen? That's that whole fully committed kind of thing, right? Amen? And when you're not fully committed, God has a way of forcing us to trust in him. Amen? We can't keep leaning to our own understanding because, as you see, it'll keep getting us into the same mess over and over again. Amen? But he said God had to force us to trust totally on him. Ah, this morning I promised I wouldn't be long, and as I get ready to close, would you say and take my seat this morning? Please know that God loves you and that he cares for you so much. He has seen all that you have been through and all that you're going through. He is not a God that does not feel our infirmities, amen? But he is always with us. Perhaps God is trying to get you to trust him totally this morning instead of taking matters into your own hand and making things worse. See, the reason the Apostle Paul could say in verses 3 and 4, praise be to God and Father, our Lord and Jesus Christ, the Father of compassion and the God of all comfort who comforts us in all troubles, is because he witnessed God showing compassion on them despite who he was. Amen? God could have said, this is the great payback. Amen? Ah, but God didn't do that. He still rescued them. And not only did he rescue them from the doom to live and tell the story, but Paul says that he would do it again and again and as many times as we need rescuing. Amen? That's when we clap. That's when we shout, amen? It means no matter how many times we find ourselves in some difficult situations, we serve a God that can and that will rescue us from our troubles, amen? Hallelujah. We serve a God who is compassionate and full of love, amen? So this morning, don't give up and don't give in. Be encouraged this morning because you have not exhausted the grace of God in your life. Hallelujah. You know what some joke is, after you offend them or do something wrong three times, it's a wrap. They don't want to fool with you no more. Amen? They may tolerate you, but it's done. They have no more compassion towards you. They ain't fooling with you, and they really don't care. But the God that we serve is not like man. Hallelujah. The God that we serve is not like man. Good God Almighty. He will come for us every time. Did you know that God is crazy about you? That he loves and he cares for you? Good God Almighty. He will rescue you from your doom. He will have compassion towards you no matter the situation. God is aware of your needs, your desires, and your struggles. He is so into you and cares for you so deeply that he is determined to be a very present help in your time of trouble. Come on here. As Paul has witnessed to us this morning, God will provide the strength and the comfort that we need. Woo, hallelujah. That's good news. That God's care for you remains steadfast and unmovable.
Yeah.
Nothing and no one could ever stop God from coming to see about you. God never wavers in caring for us and showing compassion. I was told yesterday that the choir did marvelously as they ministered a song on yesterday, and the words still ring true this morning. It says that God said he would be with you.
Yeah.
through the storm, through the rain, through the fire, through sickness and pain, amen. God said he would be with you. Yeah. God said he would be with you. So go on through your storm, amen. Go on through the rain, Sister Robinson. Go on through that sickness and go ahead and endure that pain. Because in it all, God loves you and he cares for you. And he's going to be with you, amen. God bless you, church.
Without his grace, without his faithfulness. If you've ever messed up, if you've ever fallen short, if you've ever missed the mark, but God.
But God.
But God. But God. Yeah.
He stepped in.
Thank you, God.
See, the reason why some of us we love God for real is because we knew we were guilty.
Yeah.
Now when you think you're innocent, you think you deserve to get off. But when you know you are guilty as charged.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, Lord.
And you are at the mercy of someone else, and God shows up and says, case dismissed. I'm giving them another chance. Touch the neighbor and say, that's grace and mercy. I'm telling you, if you are a recipient of another chance, you ought to give the Lord some praise. God, you gave me another chance. And you've been blessing me over and over and over again. If I had 10,000 tongues, I could not thank him enough for all that he's done for me. Amen. The Lord has been mighty kind to us, and we thank him for this word, this message on today. And we certainly pray that God has spoken to our hearts and our minds in such a way that we believe that we are better because we've been here. Amen.
Yeah.
We dare not proceed without giving the invitation for those who may have heard but have not received. If you have never accepted Jesus as Lord and Savior, have never made a public confession, has never been baptized, we certainly want to extend this opportunity for you to give your life to the Lord. It's something that God has made available for all of us. But he will not force it upon any of us.
Amen.
You have to choose God for yourself. If you're here today and you know that you are in need of salvation, you need God to help you, then we ask you to come. We invite you to come. We want to pray with you. We want to pray with you. If you're here and you're saved already, but you strayed away and you're saying, God, I'm grateful for your grace and mercy, and I want to come back. I want to repent. God, I need you, Lord God, to help me, Lord God, in this journey that I'm on. And we invite you to come. If you're here and you're looking for a church home, we invite you to come. Amen. That you might unite and partner with us, that we might serve together. And pray that God will use the gifts that you have in his kingdom. Amen. For the rest of us, we want to pray, amen, that God will continue to give us what we need in this Christian journey. Life can be difficult at times. Listen, we smile at times, we rejoice, but all the while there are persons who are fighting some real battles. Sometimes you just have to have someone to come alongside you and let you know that that they're praying with you, praying for you, and they're not going to allow you to fail, that you're not going to lose this battle. Even when people doubt you, you have to believe that God is for you. And if God be for you, he's more than the whole world against you. Listen, there are people who count you out all the time. But if God is on your side, listen, he's going to make a way somehow. For my sports people, listen. Deion Sanders, primetime, took over coaching Colorado, and they were slamming him and talking about he don't know what he's doing, and they go out there yesterday, and TCU, who was in the championship game, they end up beating them. Now the interesting thing is that the athletic director, they said that they agreed to pay him $29.5 million to coach. And they said that they didn't even have the money. But they committed to paying him $29.5 million. And once he got there, the alumni and fans donated $28 million to cover his salary. They went 1-11 last year. And in one game, his son broke the school record with 510 yards passing, 4 touchdowns, no interceptions. Everyone who said that he was going to fail, but Deion said, I believe God. Listen, when everybody else doubts you,
come on now.
Say that you don't have enough resources, you don't have experience, but the thing about Deion, he is boastful, loud and proud. And you gotta have unusual faith to believe that God is gonna do it, but even if he don't do it, he's well able. I wonder if there's anybody here today that says, God, I'm just believing you, God, for something unusual, Lord, for something extraordinary, God, that you're going to open up a window in heaven and pour out some blessings, God, that my haters are going to know that there is a God in heaven that sits high and looks low, and he's able to do exceedingly and abundantly above what you ask or think. I wish I had a shout church in here and somebody say, I believe God, I believe God. I believe him, I believe him, I believe him, I believe him. Look at your neighbor and say, won't he do it? Say, yes, he will. Yes, he will. Yes, he will. Come on, church. Won't the Lord work it out? I just believe him. I believe him. Whatever you need God to do, you ought to declare it in the name of Jesus. If you need healing, you ought to claim your healing right now, God. I don't care what the doctors say, God. I believe God. If you need a way to be made, you ought to declare it. You ought to shout it right now, God. I believe it, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Bless his name.
Amen. Listen, sometimes you gotta say it with your chest. You gotta stick your chest out and you gotta say it. Listen, I don't know what's gonna happen. I don't know how it's gonna happen, but I just believe that God is able. I believe that God is able. He's able. Amen. Listen, you do know you got some haters. You got some doubters. You got some people who don't want you to make it. And the surprising thing is that your haters don't look like haters. It's easy to identify people who oppose you, but the real haters are the ones that smile in your face. They don't want you to make it. They don't want you to pass them. They don't want you to do better than them. They don't want your children to do better than their children. But God. Listen, I just feel it in my spirit. Somebody is on the come up right now. I mean, you on a serious come up. And you on an accelerated path. You ain't taking no stairs. You taking the elevator. Look at your neighbor and say, I'm going up quick. I'm going up quick. Yeah, I'm going up quick. Yeah, see, when you take the stairs, you got to go through each level, each floor. But when you take the elevator, you just hit the floor you're going to and you go up quick. You ain't got to stop. I wish somebody would just reach up and grab that and say, Lord, I'm claiming that. That's for me. You get ready to elevate me, Lord. Sometimes it's not even about you. It's about somebody connected to you. God, I'm good, but if you could just bless my mama, bless my daddy, bless my son, bless my daughter, bless my brother, bless my sister. God, if you could just do it for them, God. Grateful we have Brother Walter who's come, amen, to unite with us by Christian experience. Amen. We're grateful for Brother Walter. Amen. We know that God is in control, and although you have gone through some challenges, God has been faithful, and we're grateful once again. We're going to ask that some of our brothers come and stand. Amen. With Brother Walter. Amen. Amen. We're grateful once again to have you, and we know that the Lord is in control. Amen. 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 You have some support. You have help here. And we're grateful once again. For those of you who are here at the altar as well, we're going to pray. Amen. I'm blessed once again. Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Amen. Blessed. We thank God for the Ivy family. Ellis, Ava, once again, continue to pray for them and pray in their strength in the Lord, and asking God to continue to comfort and strengthen them. Those of us who are here at the altar, we are praying for our families, praying for one another, that God will comfort us and strengthen us, praying for our church family as we are preparing, amen, to go to the Lord in prayer. If there are persons who are here and say, God, I'm waiting for a breakthrough. I'm waiting, Lord God, for an answer. I'm waiting, Lord,
for you, Lord God, to move. And at times you get weary. At times you get faint. And you're saying, God, I need you to renew my strength, Lord. I need you to. You need to keep me in a position of hope. Don't let the fire, don't let fear. Some of you are a lot closer than you think. Sometimes it's when you get the closest, it's when you want to give up the most. But this is not the time to quit. This is not the time to give up, to give in. You got to keep pressing. You got to keep persevering. You got to keep fighting. God, we need you. We need you, Lord. We need you to renew our minds, Lord. Give us joy. The joy of the Lord will be your strength. Sometimes you just need a new mindset. That's why the Bible talks about renewing your mind. Because when you have a new mindset, a different mindset, you begin to see things differently. You don't see struggles or burdens as burdens. You don't see closed doors as something that's blocking you. You see opportunities. But if God is going to work it out, you trust him fully and completely. There are some doors that God allows to close because you should be going in them anyway. There are some doors that are closed because what's behind it is not good enough for you. You deserve more. You deserve better. And God will close that door. And even though your hopes are set on it, he says, listen, my ways are not your ways. Because my thoughts are higher than yours. He said he'll do exceedingly abundantly above what you ask or think. Won't he do it? You gotta be passionate about what you believe God to do in your life, and it may take some time, but I'm gonna leave this one with you. Man went to McDonald's. When he went to the McDonald's, he ordered something and said, I want my sandwich without any pickles. And I don't want ketchup on it. And I want fries with no salt. He asked for some other things, and they asked him to pull up. They told him to go to this curb, pull over. And in his frustration, he was disappointed that he had to pull over. And when he got out the car, he walked over to the person at the window and says, why is it taking so long? The person at the window said, special orders take time. But somebody, you don't have a regular request. You got a special order. Look at your neighbor and say, special orders take time. There's some things God is working out for you right now. But it's going to take some time, because it's not just a normal thing. The blessing and the door he's going to open for you, it's a special order. Look at your name and say, this is a special order. We're going to pray. Listen, if you believe that you got a special order on the way, just say, Lord, give me some patience. Give me patience, Lord. Let me wait on you, God. We let us bow our head. Father God, we thank you now for your grace and for your mercy. God, we thank you for your ability, Lord God, to move in us and through us, God. We thank you, God, for the power, Lord God, that you have already released in this place. God, that we, God, we speak it and claim it in this atmosphere, God, that you are releasing an unusual anointing, God, that will open some doors, Lord God, that no man can close. Father, we thank you for elevation, God, that you are raising and lifting us up, God. We thank you right now, God, for our waiting and our labor, our toiling was not in vain, God, but that you're doing something, Lord God, that no one else can do but you. We give you the glory, the honor, and the praise right now. God, we pray that you will bless our families, Lord. We pray that you will bless the person on our left and our right, in front and behind us, God. Father, we believe that we are on our way to greater, God. God, we believe that if you are indeed and in fact in us, then it is greater than anyone else in this world or what they can do to us. God, we thank you right now, God. We thank you for Brother Walter, God. We thank you for others who are here at the altar, God. We claim and we believe, God, that this is the start of something great in our lives, that this is a new season. As we have entered this new month, we believe that we are in a new season, God, and God, you are going to get the glory, the honor, and the praise. God, we shout hallelujah, God. We shout victory, God, in the name of Jesus. Let the redeemed of the Lord say amen. 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 Come on, put your blessed hands together and shout hallelujah. 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 Amen. 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 God is good. We're going to ask First Lady that she will come once again and give us our benediction. Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. God is faithful. Amen. Amen. We're going to pray. Amen. Sorry. Damn. Father God, we just thank you, Lord, for all things. God, thank you for everything that you've allowed our ears to hear and our spirits to feel on today. God, I just pray and I thank you, God, in advance for healing. Thank you, God, for what you're doing. Thank you for salvation. Thank you for finding a home. Thank you for the connection, God, that people have found in this house on today. Now, God, that we ask that you would bless us as we depart, but never from your presence, God. I thank you for going with us as we go. Keep us safe and allow us to return to our destination safely. And I pray that we'll be able to come in here one more Sunday to give your name glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' name we pray and we say amen. Amen. Amen.